Martha was an idea that I stole from my son. In order to tell you where Martha came from, I would have to actually tell you the real story of Martha. Martha was a stray. We never saw her as a puppy. She was a very smart stray, though, and she wandered into the yard of a friend of ours, and she wouldn't leave, thereby forcing our friend to do something with her, and she tried. She had a bunch of cats, so she could not keep this little dog who was needing a home, and she called us. And so we went in to take a look, and Martha was an absolute mess. We had asked her what kind of dog this was, and she said, well, she's not cute. She's not a puppy. She said, she's kind of a Dalmatian beagle mix, I would say. So we went in there, and Martha was just a mess. So skinny, you could see her rib cage, ears hanging down, cuts on her legs, tail hanging down, and of course, fleas. Fleas, fleas, millions of fleas, the whole population of probably eastern Massachusetts. But so we took her. And the first thing we got home, we discovered that she wasn't house trained. She loved to eat the furniture. She wanted to be with us at all times. And if we couldn't take her places, that was when she turned around and tried to destroy the house. There were moments when we thought, well, you know, this was not a very good decision. But gradually, her real wonderful personality began to come out, and we began to discover many, many qualities, her wonderful qualities. She's very expressive, plainly has opinions about things, beautiful, drawable, very drawable. I wanted to find a book for her. And I slipped her into a couple of things, a poem or you know, a book. She actually had a co-starring role with Helen in The Witch's Supermarket. But the right book hadn't come up yet. And then everything, all the stars were aligned. One day, Martha, who had, of course, early on been a very hungry dog, was sitting next to my son, who was 7 years old or so, and he was eating alphabet soup. Martha trying very hard to get into his lap. Martha trying very hard to share the soup. And Nico, my creative 7-year old, said, Mom, if Martha ate alphabet soup, would she speak? And that was one of those moments when everything comes together and you think, I've got the right idea, I've got the right dog, and I know how to do this. And so, as I said, I stole it. And Martha almost writes herself. I know her personality. I know what she would do. She would speak for the dog. And, you know, the big question is, what would a dog do if they suddenly were able to speak? Of course, they wouldn't stop talking. They would not stop talking. Martha being the kind of dog she is, was, she would have a lot of things to share with people. And I know this because we had another dog named Skits who was very doggy. And if my son had said, Mom, if Skits ate alphabet soup, would he speak? And I think maybe, I don't know, it might not have happened. I think it would have been a very short article. I like sticks. What I would like to do is draw the real story of Martha. This is the non-fiction story of Martha. And this is really what I do. I draw stories. That's what a picture book is. But instead of writing the words now, I'm going to draw the pictures and speak the words. Martha was a stray. I didn't see Martha right after she was born. I didn't see her as a puppy. Somebody just let her go. Somebody just let her out the door, and she became a lost dog, hungry, sad. She was looking for someone to take care of her. She was also very smart, and she found a friend of ours working in her yard, and Martha, smart dog, walked right up to her, sat down, and refused to move. Our friend did everything you do for a dog who is lost. She did everything. She called every agency. She put up signs. Nobody wanted this dog, so she called us. And we say, well, what does this dog look like? And she said, well, she's not cute. She's not a puppy. She's just kind of a white Dalmatian beagle combination. So we went in, and this is what we saw. The first time we saw Martha. Her ears hung down, just the way a sad dog's ears hang down. She was so skinny, every single rib showed. Her tail just hung down the way a sad dog's tail hangs down. She had cuts on her legs. We didn't know where those came from. And she had fleas! Thousands and thousands and thousands of fleas! The whole population of fleas in eastern Massachusetts, possibly the whole state. So of course we took her home. And when we got home, we discovered some things about Martha. The first thing we discovered about Martha was that she didn't trust us. She didn't trust us for 1 minute. And she decided that the way to make sure that we didn't leave her, that we didn't get tired of her, that we didn't do the same thing to her that had already been done to her, was to stay with us at all moments. And with this in mind, she followed us everywhere. She followed us up the stairs in the kitchen, her favorite place. She slept in the bed, thereby starting a tradition of dogs sleeping in our bed. And she was very careful to make sure she knew where we were at all times. Occasionally, we had to go someplace without her. And when we did this, we'd have to sneak out of the house. If we succeeded and we got to the other side of the door, we would hear Martha racing across the floor, boom, against the door, and this is what we would hear. And this is how she would look. Don't go. That might have been the first time I heard her talk. And then the thing that would happen is, once she realized that we'd gone out without her, she would turn right around and start destroying the house. Well, another thing we learned about her, took her to the vet, got rid of her fleas, and the first thing the vet said was, ah, a pit bull cross. But we discovered the morning that we came down and found our 2-year-old sitting with Martha, and Martha had clothespins on both ears, and she was grimacing, but she wasn't doing anything else. And then we realized this is a great dog.
For more author interviews, recommended reading lists, and information about teaching kids to read, please visit us online at www.readingrockets.org.